Number three, the Cleveland Cavaliers. They re-signed Kevin Love. Most thought he would bolt. And then re-signing Iman Shumpert. But the key piece was getting a backup point guard, a guy that could produce, a guy that you can count on in the playoffs, and they got it in Mo Williams. I think he was a huge find. Number two, the San Antonio Spurs. Now, most think the Spurs are the clear-cut winner. Now, I'm going to hold off thought for a second, and here's the reason. Yes, they signed LaMarcus Aldridge, who was the plum of the free agent pool. They got a steal in David West, who bypassed a $12 million option and signed for the veteran minimum. They re-signed Danny Green, Manu Ginobili. They come back with Patty Mills and Boris Diaw. But they lost a core group of guys that stepped in when injuries abound and Greg Popovich wanted to rest. And that is Tiago Splitter, Marco Bellinelli, Corey Joseph, and Aaron Baines. Now, they accumulated 75 minutes a game and 30 points. That has to be replaced, especially the way Greg Popovich coaches during the regular season. Number one, the Milwaukee Bucks. They got, I think, one of the most talented big men in the NBA, Greg Monroe. He's a beast in the paint, and he can pass the ball adequately. And guess what? He's going to be passing it to newly re-signed Chris Middleton, Michael Carter-Williams, the Greek Freak, and the healthy Jabari Parker. That immediately, in my estimation, elevates the Milwaukee Bucks to a top four seed in the Eastern Conference. I think they are that good, and they are the big winner.